Well, hi everybody, it's Sandy, artist and paper crafter here on YouTube, and I'm going to give you a little vanishing point lesson today so you can learn how to do a floor in a laundromat. It's going to be a really fun card. This is a new stamp set from Lawn Fawn. It's got this washer slash dryer. You can use it for either one, and it's got little clothes that you can put in it. Lots of people will use the opening for a shaker card and put the clothing in it. I'm going to do something a little different. But I'm going to use these bottom images on the inside of my card, and then I'm going to stamp images into the opening on the washer or the dryer. I think it's going to be a washer in my case. And I'm going to talk about the vanishing point, because the way this is drawn, it has a natural vanishing point. I wanted to lay it out for my card, so I started stamping on the plastic sheet first just to get it lined up and see how many of these will work on my card. And what I started seeing was that there's this vanishing point not here on all of them. So I'm going to show you how to make the vanishing point match on all of these guys together. So I'm starting by stamping my first one, my main one, on my Neenah cardstock. And I have that all ready to go. It's stamped with some Memento ink. And then I'm going to mask off the bottom portion of it. And the reason is because I want to move over the other washers and dryers. And I need to do it in such a way that they don't end up looking like they're in a different perspective. So perspective is something that I want to be aware of. So here, I want to slide this over so I only get that top left section right there, and I don't want that little angled line on the top. You'll see how all this plays out in just a minute. So I'm just using some Post-it notes and 2-inch masking tape to block things off, so I'm only stamping that top section right up there. So I'll peel all of this off, and you can see now I've got the tops all lined up. They look normal, and I want to fix the bottoms. And I only want to do the bottom squares. I don't want to do the top section, because the top section is the part that has that vanishing point, and we'll talk a little further about that, and you'll see why it's important when we get there. So I'm going to stamp the left-hand side and the right-hand side, so that I have a line of washers in the laundromat. When I was in college, I totally went to the laundromat all the time. This stamp set brought back all kinds of memories of that. So now I'm taking a ruler, and this is a rolling ruler that I've got. You can use any kind of ruler for this. And I'm following along the lines that are drawn in the stamp set that show the perspective. Now, lots of times you'll see perspective lessons with buildings and all that sort of thing, but it works with something like this, because they've angled the top of it so that they go back to a vanishing point. So now we want to do a floor, but we want to do a vanishing point on the floor that's going to match the vanishing point on the washer, because I want to do a checkerboard tile floor. So I've marked every half inch down below, and then I'm going to take my ruler and line up along each one of them. So I'm going to make little marks. I'm not going to go all the way to the vanishing point, because I know the vanishing point is there. I'm just going to do that bottom section down there. Now, depending on what image you have, you may end up finding that your vanishing point is way off your paper. Here it happens to still be on the paper, but just tape it down to something like I've done. If your vanishing point goes way off into the distance, then it's still going to work the same kind of way. The horizontals are still going to remain horizontal, but they're going to get bigger. The little boxes, the blocks of the tile, are going to get larger as they kind of wend their way forward. So the further they are, the smaller they get, and then they get bigger. So don't worry about it too much. It's only a card, but you can make them, you know, kind of extend a little bit bigger, a little bit smaller in order to increase that perspective. So I've put my shading down at the bottom first, because I'm going to put the color on top of it. Especially if you're going to do colored tiles, you want to put that gray down first, or else the gray will displace the color. And now I'm going to use my Copic markers to shade my little washers and dryers. And I want to make the edges look like they're a little bit round. So I took a dark gray marker, or a medium gray marker, and then I'm just softening it with a C1, a light gray. And you can go with lighter grays. My dark colors scare people a lot, so use lighter grays if you want. And then I'll just add a little bit of shading underneath each one of the circles on the front, because those usually stick out a little bit, so there would be a little shadow under them. The center one I'm going to cover with an action wobble, but I was going to use it as practice. It's always good if you're going to do an action wobble on top of something, you can practice your coloring on the one underneath. So I wanted to see how much gray I wanted on it. This was more than I wanted, so I'll use less when I get to doing the finished one that's gonna be on the action wobble portion. And now I'm just gonna fill in all those blocks, well, every other block along the way. So just gonna color them in with a dark gray marker. You can use a black marker, you can make it a checkerboard, all kinds of different colors, floor, whatever you want. It doesn't have to be a black and white floor, but for a laundromat, I thought this worked just perfect. So I've colored in some of the other portions, just solid colors, a red, a yellow, and a blue-green color. And then I'll fill in this little strip on each one of them with the same dark gray that's in the bottom down below. I'm just gonna limit my color palette. There's no reason to get too crazy when I'm trying to go for a really simple look like this with a simple color palette. I'm gonna shade all of my colors, all of my little buttons, with just a little half circle of the darker gray. And then I'm gonna take a Signo white pen and just add a couple of dots, like a dot and a half. Not too the same size, just a little bit different, and then that makes it look like they've got little highlights on them. And I'll do a little bit of a line on those yellow boxes and call it good for the coloring on that. Now I've stamped another one of the washers onto another piece of paper, and I'm gonna trim out this outside box so I can just scribble around the edges and get my shading the same way as I did on the others. I'm being a little careful on that center circle shadow because I liked having a little bit less of that gray in there. And now I wanted to figure out how to mask all of this out. I didn't buy the die set for this, kicking myself now for not doing it, but I found a punch that was gonna work for this. It's a 1¾-inch punch. So I just took a couple pieces of that masking tape and punched half circles out of them so that I could mask it and then throw all these little bits of laundry in there. So I'm gonna add bubbles, and that's how I know mine is a washer, because it has bubbles in it. If it was not, it would be the dryer. But I decided I'd put the little faces on them too, because the Lawn Fawn sets always have cute faces in everything, because that makes everything adorable. And I'm gonna run through and just do very simple, straightforward coloring on this, because the really crazy fun part of this has been already creating that scene with all those washers, and then doing the action wobble portion, which we're gonna do in a minute. So the coloring on this does not have to be rocket science, just so you know. But you could, you know, if you wanted to keep it super simple and yet have something really special, you could add glossy accents just onto the glass portion, which would be very cool. So I'm just adding some real simple shading with some grays and then calling it done. And I've trimmed it out. Now this is an action wobble. If you haven't seen one, you can do it two ways. Both, they're sticky on both sides, and you can look at which way they kind of fling around and play around with them. You know, see which one goes both horizontally. So if you tap it on the top surface, how does it bounce? Does it bounce the way that your image would bounce? Because there's some images that will bounce a little differently than other images. And some of them will also, you'll want them to twirl a little more than they do bounce. So pay attention to which direction you're placing it down on, but it can be top and bottom either direction as long as it works for the card that you want. So I'm gonna quickly run through and do the coloring on the inside. And again, I'm doing the same colors as I used on the outside of the card, but just carrying them through to the inside. I'm gonna do simple shading with grays and not get crazy with it, because again, the fact that I've even added anything to the inside is extra special. People aren't used to having a little extra decor on the inside. So even just having my sentiments stamped in two different colors, you know, that just adds a little feature to the inside that wouldn't normally be there. So I'm gonna let my coloring be real simple, add just a little bit of gray shadows, use the same two grays, soften those out, and call it done. So I've got this added onto a card base. I just glued the whole card front onto a card base, and I went, wait a minute, I didn't put anything inside these other windows. So I just threw some gray in there, just the same two grays, blend it out. I'm not looking to make it look like it's like major glass, but again, you could throw glossy accents on all three of the windows and it would be very cute, because everybody's going to be looking at the action wobble one. They're not going to be looking at the other stuff, but if you wanted to add more, you could do that. You could also add glossy accents onto the buttons, which would be fun. But I think the card is just adorable, and I wish that I knew somebody in college who had a birthday coming up. My nieces already had their birthday because I think this would be great for a college kid. So here's a couple more videos if you're interested in seeing some more from me. There is a subscribe button. If you're not yet subscribed, feel free to click that and you'll get more videos from me, about 3 a week. There's more information on the blog, still pictures of this card, etc. And you can always click on any of the links in the doobly-doo where all the supplies are listed. Thank you so much for joining me today, and have an awesome day. Go out and create something beautiful. See you later. Bye-bye.